Hello students, welcome to the course Network Theory. In the previous 4 to 5 videos, we tried to discuss or analyze mesh using different scenarios like independent voltage sources, independent current sources, dependent voltage sources, dependent current sources, and also we have seen the super mesh analysis. Okay, so in today's video, we will discuss the mesh analysis for AC networks. Okay, so there is something kind of new. Okay, so the whatever you have done analysis so far, now we'll extend that to now AC networks. And here we could not use directly using calculator. If you got the equations, calculator could not use. As I mentioned earlier, you have to use the Cramer's rule. Okay, so such one example we try to solve in this one or two examples we try to solve in this video. Okay. So mesh analysis for AC network, the only difference between AC and DC, okay, so AC and DC network is that resistance R is the only element which is considered in DC circuits. Okay, whereas in AC circuits we come across the element impedance Z. So instead of resistance R, we have the impedance Z, which is the combination of resistance and reactance X. Okay, so it will be written like this. Okay, so Z is equal to resistance plus jx. Okay, so resistance plus jx, so x is the reactance here, r is the resistance. In the DC networks, this reactance term is zero, that's why you have z into zero, so no this term, only r will be there. Okay, so that is only the difference. And in the case of reactive element, so it may have resistor as well as reactive combination, or alone it can have a reactive combination. Okay, so again this reactance will be a different way notated for inductance and capacitance. Inductance it is XL, and for capacitance it is XC. Okay, so if you extend this, okay, XL is nothing but omega into L, because in AC network you don't have a constant DC. Okay, so you have the alternating. Okay, so alternating AC means you have the frequency over the time will be measured. So this omega is nothing but here 2 phi f. So omega is given as 2 phi into f, frequency in hertz, and this omega is angular frequency, okay, in radian per second. Okay, 2 phi fl, so that is the extension for this xl. Okay, so in problem, so they may give you just inductance value xl, l also they can give, so you have to find out the xl from that. So just multiply 2 phi frequency and l, so you'll get omega into l. Okay, so that is nothing but the XL, so that you substitute here, you will get the R plus J term. Okay, that is the impedance. Okay, so normally in problem they will give the J terms directly. Okay, so normally with respect to inductance you will have the plus J term, with capacitance minus J. Why it is so, we'll see, because XC is given as 1 by omega C. Okay, so XC is denoted as 1 by omega C, which is nothing but 1 by 2 phi FC. Okay, so that is nothing but 1 by jxc. Okay, so 1 by, so this will be in the denominators when you take this is one notation is there, so j is a complex term, so if you take 1 over j, which is nothing but minus j. Okay, so that's why, since it is a reciprocal in capacitance, so you'll normally have minus term with capacitance. Okay, so whatever I have told you, you may not understand, but in the problem you will come to know. In problem we'll straight away give this, okay, either resistance in series with this or parallel with that. Okay, based on that we'll find out the impedance term of that. Okay, so this is normally the concept of reactance. Okay, just try to explain it. Okay, so the reactance may be either inductive reactance XL or capacitive reactance XC. Okay, so this is XL equal to omega L equal to 2 phi FL. X is 1 by omega, X is omega C, but it will be denoted as minus J XC. Okay, because 1 by XC will be there, so it is minus J XC will be written, which is nothing but minus 1 by omega C. Omega C is nothing but, omega is angular frequency, and then C. Okay, so 2 phi F into C. Okay, so that is about the AC network. Okay, so whatever we have discussed in DC network separately, we will not try to do. We'll just do tell you how to solve, okay, using the calculator as well as the Cramer's rule, how to apply that, that we'll try to show it here. Okay, so just note down the problem. So the number you, so before that some more things, source, with respect to source, The sources are represented by their effective values E or I. Okay, so if it is voltage source E, current source I. So notation V also can be used in some books, or in the form of equation for their instantaneous values. Okay, because this E in AC can be represented as magnitude with sinusoidal or cosine term. Okay, so Em sine omega t plus phi, like that. Okay, so here it is shown, which is Em sine omega t plus or minus phi. So phi means phase. Okay. Omega means frequency, and then this is magnitude. The three terms that will combination will tell you the instantaneous value, we say. Okay, similarly for current also, current magnitude of that current, okay, sinusoidal term, frequency, and then phase. Okay, so which is nothing but if you have a AC signal, okay, so it may be sine or cosine. Okay, so based on, normally we'll use the sine, so it will have the peak, right? This is Im or Em, we will say. And then which angle it will take. So if frequency is high, so frequency is measured over the one clock cycle. So this is called as time, right? So one clock cycle is equal to period T. If you take 1 by T, which is nothing but the frequency. So if this waveform drawn like this, okay, so then it's a time is less, so frequency is more, like that. Okay, so that is the frequency. And phase means this orientation. Okay, so how it is oriented. Okay, so it is almost related with the frequency itself. Okay, so that is with respect to source, and that is with respect to elements. Okay, so you have RLC term along with voltage source or current source. Okay, so just note down the problem. So simple one. So don't bother about this number. So whatever numbers you are following, just try to note down. It's my notebook. It is this number. The network in figure contains two voltage source E1 and E2. Okay. The problem is given E1 and E2, and they have given E1. If E1 is equal to 50 angle 0 degree volt. Okay. So in the complex term, we have two notations. One is magnitude at an angle we can represent, or we can show like this. Okay. It is the real part versus and complex part. Okay. So this is the rectangular form and polar form, we will say. Okay. Polar form and rectangular form. Both conversion is possible using the calculator. Okay. So what they have asked is find E2. Okay, so in this network, just you see, so here E1 is there, this is a AC, that's why notation is changed. So here you have a 5 ohm resistance, then you have j5 ohm, nothing but here inductance, that's why plus you observe here. And here you have 4 ohm plus j3, they are in series, so it is already written in reactance, so straight away it is added like r plus jx. okay, so 4 plus j3 ohm, and this 6 ohm, and this 4 ohm. Okay. And here the voltage source is given. This is E2. So E1 value they have given 50 at an angle 0 degree volt. And these values they have given in complex term. So we have to come to some neutral form. So normally we'll come to this polar form, and then we'll convert it into rectangular form. Keep the answer. Okay. So we'll see that. So what they have asked is, they told you to find out the E2. What is given? Current in 4 plus J3 ohm. That is, what is current in 4 plus J3 ohm means? Which is nothing but I2. I2 current is 0. So here no need to solve all the three currents here like mesh analysis, but you have to write the mesh equations. Okay, and we have to write the delta, and then delta 2 we can write for I2 current. So then we can find the I2, and which we equate it to 0, we'll try to get the E2 voltage. So that is what the concept in this problem. Okay, so just first what we'll do, using the general concept, we'll try to write the equations now. Okay, so here applying KVL also you can write the equations. Okay, like E1. So this is plus minus, this side arrow means plus minus is there. So E1 minus phi into I1 minus J5 I1 minus I2, like that's also you can write. Or now you have familiar with this one, general analysis, straight away we can use. What is the self loop? So which is 5 plus J5 ohm. Straight away we can add 5 plus J5 ohm into I1 minus between 1 and 2, you have J5. So minus J5, it is mutual. So minus J5, I2. I3 term is not there, so it is 0, equal to current. So current is in the direction of voltage. So it is equal to 50 at an angle 0 degree volt. Correct. Similarly, you write the equation for I2. So self mutual with I1 is minus J5 I1. Then with respect to this, so add the real term separately. You have 6 plus 4, 10. J5 plus J3, J8. So 10 plus J8 ohm you'll get, and the current is I2, which is plus. And then with respect to 3, you have 6. So minus 6, I3. Okay, so there is no voltage source here equate to zero. Similarly, third term, so with respect to one you don't have, so zero I1. Then with respect to I2 you have 6, so minus 6 I2. And with respect to I3 you have 6 plus 4. So there is no reactance term here. So 6 plus 4, 10. So 10 I3. Here see the current direction is downwards and voltage direction upwards. So you need to equate equal to minus E2. So this is the three equations. Okay. So just you observe. The three mesh equations are, so whatever I have told you there, the same thing it is written over here. 5 plus J5 I1 minus J5 I2 plus 0 I3 equal to 50 at an angle 0 degree. If you convert this into J form, so you'll get 50 itself. Okay, 50 plus 0 J you will get. So 0 J means no value. So that's why 50 is written. Okay, you can try it in calculator. It's there. I will show you later for when solving the problem. I will show you once, then you can come back and verify this. Okay. Second equation, same way, minus J5 I1 plus 10 plus J8 I2 minus 6 I3 equal to 0. 0 I1 minus 6 I2. No need to write this, but for your calculation, if you miss that, okay, in hurry, if you write A3 as minus 6, so problem, right? That's why we'll try to write 0 I1 minus 6 I2 plus 10 I3 equal to minus E2. So here straight away, you could not use the equations here in straight away because J terms are there. Okay, so it is a complex term, so you could not use the equations as you have done in DC networks. Okay, so what we do is, so we write this equation in a matrix form. Okay, so matrix form, so see here all the three equations, first term is I1, second term is I2, third term is I3, and the last term is all constants. Okay, normally the values of the voltage sources. Okay, so now this we will write it, so all the coefficients of I1, I2, I3 will write it in a matrix form and we will denote it. Okay, so this is the matrix form here. 5 plus J5 minus J5 0 minus J5 plus J10 minus 6. Okay, this is I1 term, this is I2 term, this is I3 term. Okay, so then I1, I2, I3 is written. If you do the matrix multiplication here, so this term with I1, this term with I2, this term with I3, so you'll get the same equation itself. Okay, and all the constant right sum, we have written another matrix here, 50, 0 and minus E2. Okay, so from this, how to write the delta for the Cramer's rule. In the very first video of mesh analysis, I told you about the Cramer's rule. So now I am applying that. Okay, so delta. So delta means what? Determinant of the matrix. Okay, so this matrix, we are finding the determinant. So just we'll use this notation, right? So this notation we'll use for determinant. So matrix, we'll just have a curve here like that. Okay, that is only the difference. So 5 plus J5, same thing copied over here. Okay, so now we can solve for delta, but is it necessary? So whatever the problem asked for, same way we need to solve the problem, right? So what they have told is find out the value of E2, they have told, right? Given current I2 is zero. So accordingly, we'll go with the flow. Okay, so this is the question. Find E2 such that current in 4 plus J3 ohm is zero. So straight away we can take current I2 is equal to zero. What is meant by I2? So then if necessary, we'll solve for delta, okay? So that is what shown over here. So this is, since the current through 4 plus J3 ohm is 0, so I2 is equal to 0. Okay, so I2 is equal to, so what is I2? So what you have to do is constant term, whatever is there, you have to place it in the first term. Okay, so sorry, I2 means second term. So first term is as it is, 5 plus J5 minus J5 0. Okay, with the delta. Then second term we need to replace with the constant right side term, that is 50, 0 and minus E2, you have to replace it. Okay, and then third term as it is, 0 minus 6, 10. Okay, so actually this we have shown it as delta 2 by delta. Okay, straight away I have written it. So I2 is nothing but delta 2 by delta is equal to 0. Okay, so if you cross multiply delta into 0, so you'll get delta 2 is equal to 0. That means what? This value, okay, so this value, determinant of this value should be equal to 0. Delta 2 is equal to 0. So that's why no need to calculate delta here. So it is multiplied with 0, already 0. So now this we have to find out using matrix multiplication. So 5 plus J5 is the term is there here. Just if you confuse here. Okay, so this is the term first plus, second term will be minus and third term we will have plus. This is the notation, right? Plus 5 plus J5 into, so you need to take the determinant of this, okay, inner one, okay, so 0 into 10 0 minus, so again here you have minus term, so minus minus plus 6e2 with respect to this minus, so minus 6e2 you will get. Okay, then you have minus term here, minus 50. Then next determinant is with respect to this row and this row, except this, right? So minus j5 into 10 is minus j50 and minus 6 into 0. So anything is 0, so that's why it is not written. And third term is 0, multiplication term. So if you multiply with this, anything is 0. So that's why that term is not written. Okay. So now what is the thing? The problem is simplified now. So you need to simply find out the e2 here. Okay. So all the terms are there. So just you need to solve the e2. Okay. So how to do that? So first we'll take up e2 outside. Minus 6 will multiply with each term. Minus 6 into 5, minus 30. Minus 6 into 5, minus 30j. Minus 30 minus 30j into e2. And here minus minus plus 50, 2500j. Okay. So that is what shown next. So minus 30 minus j30 into e2 plus j2500 equal to 0. Okay. And then I need to find out e2 here. So to find out e2, what I have to do, I have to take this right side. So what will become? This is minus, right? 0 minus this is minus j2500 divided by coefficient of e2 term. That is minus 30 minus 30j. So now to do this calculation, you have your calculator. Okay. So from calculator, so you have to take this ratio. Okay. And then you have to solve this. And this is the polar form. And then from polar form, you can convert it into rectangular form. Okay. So how to get this? So I will share a video. So just a minute. Give me a minute. I will share the video. Just look at that, how you can use the calculator for this. Okay.
In this, I will tell you how to solve this complex to rectangular calculation. So you have the minus J2500. So for that, first you have to enter mode, okay, complex mode, okay, 2. So now 0, okay, so that you have to consider minus 2500. So notation in calculator, it will be I. So here it will be there, just if you press ENG button, so I will come, divided by, so you have to put the bracket if you have two terms. So denominator you have minus 30 minus 30j. J in the calculator it will be I. Okay. And always you have to write the I terms on the right side. Okay, not I 30. So it should be 30i you should write. So when you press equal, so you'll get the A term. Okay. So that is the real term, real part. Okay. And if you click shift equal to, so you'll get the, here C. This is the I term. Okay. So 41 point. So that is what shown in the calculation. So now just if you press shift, so here at the button of plus, you have R at an angle theta. Okay. Just you can observe. So if you make this calculation, so you'll get the real part calculation, that is 58.92 you are getting. And if you press one more time shift equal to, so you'll get the angle part, which is shown here, angle, and this is the angle 45 degree. So that is what shown in the problem. Thank you.
Okay, hope you have understood this calculation. So have you got this a plus jb term? And then we have converted into rectangular term, 58.925 at an angle 45 degree. So this is the answer. So as they have given E1 as 50 at an angle 0 degree volts, right? The same way, this is now E2, this value at an angle 45 degree volts. Okay. So this is nothing but the phase. Okay. So hope you have understood how to solve a AC network. Similarly, we'll see another problem quickly. Okay. So just note down the problem. So in the single page, you have all the question and answers, everything here. Okay, simple problem. So note down the question, determine V23. Okay, so that is voltage between, voltage between 2 to 3, that is the node. Okay, so 2 is here and between 3, that is a voltage divider rule. So you need to find out here V23 by mesh analysis for the network shown in figure. So this is the network, 1 amp current source, 3 ohm, and this is J4 ohm, and here 2 ohm, J2 ohm. Okay. So you need to find out between here, okay, So that is the problem. So just note down this. Okay. So solution. So straight away we could not apply here this one Kirchhoff's voltage law. So for that, what we have done, we have used the source elementary source operation. Okay, source shifting operations I have done. So using source shifting, what I have done? So this 1 amp, whatever going from here and entering over here, so which can be divided among these two terminals, right? So 1 and 3. Okay, so this may be 3 and 1. Another terminal. So we have divided like this. Okay, so 1 amp and then 1 amp. So what happened now? This is a current source in parallel with resistance. Here current source in parallel with inductance. Okay, so same thing applies whatever we have done with respect to inductance also. So now if you convert this, remaining thing is as it is. So voltage source, how you find out? V is equal to IR. So 1 into 3 is 3 ohm. Okay, 3 volt, and the arrow side is upward, right? So plus minus 3 volt and 3 ohm won't change, right? Similarly here, 1 amp into J4 ohm, so the voltage is J4 volt. Okay, so this also will come in complex form. Okay, it is possible, as we have seen in previous case in rectangle form. Now the voltage is in complex form. Okay, polar form. Okay, and the J4, it will not change J4 ohm. So now you got a single loop here. Okay, so you can easily apply the Kirchhoff's voltage law, and you can find out the current first, and then you can find out the terminal voltage between 2 and 3. Okay, that is what done. So first we'll apply the mesh analysis. So what you have here, J4 minus plus is there. Okay, so that's why I have taken plus J4. Then J4 I, so current is I, so J4 I, that is written minus. Then this is minus, plus is there. So normally this is plus minus will be there. Okay, current direction, this is plus minus. Then this is plus minus, and this is also plus minus. Okay, like this. So here a minus plus is there, J4 minus J4 I, then plus 3, minus plus is there, plus minus, minus 3 I, then it is plus minus, so minus 2 I, again this is plus minus, so minus J2 into I equal to 0. So now real part terms you group it, and complex this J part you group it here. Okay, this is all J term. So 3 is there, and then only 3 you have, only one term, and J4 is there. Okay, without I, 3 plus J4, that is separated here, minus with respect to I term again. So you have here minus 3 minus 2. So that's what, minus 5 here, and then minus J4 minus J2. So it is minus J6. So minus taken outside, that's why 5 plus J6 into I equal to 0. So from this, so 3 plus J4 is equal to 5 plus J6 I. This is taken right side, it became plus. Now from this, I is equal to 3 plus J4 by 5 plus J6. You know how to do this calculation now from the calculator, but still we'll keep it in same format because we require the voltage here. Okay, that is the voltage from this 2 to 3. Okay, so this 2 to 3 we want. So what is connected over here? It is 3 ohm and 2 ohm. Okay, so from voltage divider law. So this is I into R here. Okay, 3 plus J4 by 5 plus J6 by Ohm's law. Okay, so that is the current here, what we have measured in this circuit, into the resistance here. Resistance connected between 2 to 3 is, it is 3 ohm and 2 ohm. They are in series, right? So 3 plus 2 is 5. That is what mentioned here. So now this 5 is multiplied with numerator term. So 3 into 5 is 15 plus J into 5 into 4 is 20. Okay, so this is 15 plus J20 you got. Denominator is same. So now you have to calculate this as we have done previously, and then you have to keep this in the magnitude at an angle form. Okay, so again, to understand this, I will share another video how I do this in calculator. Okay, so give me a minute.
Hello students, similar way we'll solve another problem here. So what you have here is, first we convert it to complex mode. So then enter the, so numerator also you have two terms, so take the brackets here, 15 plus J20 is there, so we should enter here 20 I. okay, divided by again bracket. So in the denominator you have 5 plus J6, that means 5 plus 6 I you should click, so which gives answer 3.196, which is the real part. And if you click shift equal to, so you'll get the imaginary part. So 0.16399. Okay, so which is not shown, but directly if you convert shift plus, that is r at an angle theta, so you'll get the magnitude term, that is 3.2. 0.00 is there, 3.2 we have considered. Then again shift equal to, if you make, you'll get the angle part, which is 2.935. okay, so we can take two or three or four decimals. Okay, that's what the answer you have. Okay, thank you.
Okay, so hope you have understood the mesh analysis, how we can apply for AC networks. Okay, like that plenty of problems you will get if you refer, many textbooks are there, you can refer the old question papers also. Meanwhile, I will give some assignments also as the colleges re-begin. So this is what I am completing the portion of the third part of the module one, which is mesh analysis completely. Okay, so all the different concepts we have considered and separately we have solved it. Okay, similar way we will apply it to now node analysis. So in the next video we'll discuss node voltage analysis. Okay, so how we have dependent voltage, independent voltage, so super node, and for AC networks how we solve. So another next few video we'll be discussing the node voltage analysis, which is the dual of this. Okay, so some of the things are similar to that, so we can go quickly with the node analysis. Okay, so with this, so we'll end this session. We'll see in the next video. Okay, thank you.